So the Bible says, do not be afraid. David said in Psalm 23, verse 4, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, no evil will I fear, because God is there. The COVID-19 we are battling, the virus itself, there are many people who have hurt themselves even when the virus has not come near them because of fear. Out of fear, some people have taken chloroquine and ended in the hospital. They didn't even have the virus. The virus has not come, but they took chloroquine in order to stop the virus that hasn't come. And now they have hurt themselves. I had to cancel somebody who was like one of our parishioners, a lady. What is your problem? Father, I can't sleep. I am coughing. I said, okay, go to the hospital. I was very sure it was fear. You know, fear can make even normal cough that you used to have before. When you cough, you begin to suspect yourself. Fear can make you to begin to have the symptoms of what you are scared of, even when it is not there. And it is real, because fear is real. And fear is powerful. We must not. David said, though I walk, there are shadows of darkness, but I will not be afraid. Psalm 91, verse 5. He said, you will not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor this plague that prowls in the darkness, nor the scourge that lays waste at noon. You should not be afraid, because why? The Lord is your shelter. Those who call the Lord their shelter, their stronghold, should not be afraid. The only fear that is held is the fear of God. So Psalm 111 verse 10 says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Yeah? Proverbs 10:27 says, the fear of the Lord increases your lifespan. 14:27, it says that the fear of the Lord is the fountain of life. Then same Proverbs 29:25 says, the fear of man is a trap. Just like the apostles trapped themselves. It's a snare. So what are you scared of? So many Christians are scared of things they shouldn't be scared of. You see a black cat in the night. Oh, you begin to perspirate. You begin to shake and stuff like that. So do not be afraid. The apostles locked themselves. Where have you locked yourselves? There are some things that can make you lock yourself by yourself. Doubt can make you lock yourself. Some people have locked themselves perpetually in the room of sadness because of unforgiveness. Unforgiveness has made you to lock yourself in the room of sadness. Whenever you see this person or you remember what the person has done to you, you are perpetually sad. You don't want to come out of it because you locked yourself. Not another person did that to you. So Thomas was a courageous person. He was not there. So then, when Jesus came, another thing we should notice about Thomas is that Thomas was not the only person who needed to see. He said, until I see these things, I will not believe. It was not like he was even different from the other apostles. They too saw before they believed. Okay, look at that gospel message again. Say, Jesus came and stood among them and said to them, peace be with you. There was no reaction from them. They were still looking. Then he said, the Bible said, when he had said this, he showed them his hand. He did what? He showed them. So they had to see. It was when he showed them his hands and his side, then the Bible said, then the disciples were glad when they saw the Lord. So they were not even different from Thomas. Sometimes we think we are different from others. We are not too different too. All of us are the same. Now the same thing, the warriors. They were not different from Thomas. They saw. In fact, if you read the Gospel of Mark chapter 16, Mark makes it very clear. The women told them, but they refused to believe. Then when Jesus came, the Bible said Jesus was even like quarreling them for refusing to believe from the witnesses of the women, all of them. So Thomas here is more like a dramatic representation of the entire disciples. So Jesus had to show them. There too they saw. So Thomas was not the only one.
To watch full videos and get notifications for new ones, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. God bless you.
Sign up with the largest community of Catholics online, meet new friends, chat, post pictures and videos, make and receive audios and video calls, interact with lots of priests and religious. Download the app from Google Play Store.